Hello students, myself Saurabh Maheshwari, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Engineering, Government Women Engineering College, Ajmer, and I welcome you all to the ongoing lecture series on Fundamental of Computers and Programming in C. And in today's video, we will cover arrays in C. And in this video, you will be able to learn following outcomes, that how to store data about multiple items of same data type. Concept of arrays, we will learn how to declare the array, initialize an array indexing, and so many topics we will cover during the course of time. Okay, so let us start from the concept that this concept is there, same data type. Now what do you understand by data type, right? All of you know that there are some data types available in C, that is data types, inbuilt data types are available in C. Okay, so inbuilt data types are integer, character, and float. Okay, so till now what you have learned, if you know how to create variables, suppose I want to create an integer variable, I would simply write int a. Okay, what does it mean? It means that a is an integer. Okay, its name is A, and it might have its address, which may be 1000, and since each integer take 2 bytes, okay, or 4 bytes as different standards of C, okay, I am taking as 2 bytes, so integer takes 2 bytes, so 1000 and 1001, these 2 bytes, these 2 addresses of bytes of a byte addressable memory. It means every byte of the memory is given an address. Okay, so that is, in a byte addressable memory, for 2 bytes each integer is given 2 addresses. Okay, so the name of integer is this, and as we write a equals to 5, what happens, a equals to 5, now we have also learned how to convert the numbers of decimals to the number systems that are understood by the computer. So this a equals to 5 is converted into this 5. This 5 is converted into its 16-bit binary equivalent. Okay, binary equivalent. And this 16-bit, you can see that there are 2 bytes reserved for this particular variable. So the byte number 1000 and 1001, these 2 bytes are used to store, these 2 bytes means 16 bits, and the 16-bit a binary equivalent is stored in these 2 bytes of the data. So this 5 is converted into 16-bit equivalent, and the 16-bit equivalent, it is stored in this memory space. Okay, but for now, for understanding purpose, I will directly write that 5 is stored over here. So what do we say, that a is in the memory, and these 2 are the memory addresses, and at these 2 memory addresses the value 5 is stored, which is value of this integer with the name a. Okay, now in a sequential statement, if I do this, a equals to 7. Now what happens with the value? Okay, as soon as you write a equals to 7, yes, you all are correct, that this 5 is replaced or overwritten by another value, that is 7. Okay, now the term is that overwritten. Okay, so you have to understand this concept, that memory spaces are not deleted. Okay, they can only be overwritten. Okay, so deletion is nothing but forgetting a value of particular integer. Okay, there is nothing like a concept of deletion means evaporating or something, removal of value, like deleting this a will not go, that this 5 is completely removed from the place. Okay, it cannot happen. Okay, memories can only be overwritten. Okay, so as soon as we put a equals to 7, the previous value of a, which was 5, is overwritten. Okay, so 5 is overwritten, so this 7 takes place of 5. or the 16-bit binary equivalent of this 7, okay, now takes place in these two bytes for particular representation of this A. Okay, now as soon as you do A equals to 2, again the value of A is changed to 2 from 7. Okay, now what to note? Okay, you can note that a variable which we have declared till now, a variable can hold only one value at a time. Okay, now holding a one value at a time, it is not a problem to do, right? Because it is a concept and variable has to store a value. But the problem comes when you have multiple values of same data type. Suppose I want to store marks of 5 students, right? So at a time, a variable can take only one value. So what I need to do, I need to prepare, suppose marks, I will take my M1 for storing marks of first student, M2 for marks of second student, M3 for 4, M4 for 4, M5 for 5. So these 5 variables I have to declare to store marks of 5 students. Now imagine the complexity of the number of variables when you have to store marks of 60 students or whole college. Okay, so that will make a problem for us to use these single variables for storing multiple items. Okay, and specifically multiple items of same data type. Okay, this is an important thing to understand. Okay, now you can see that the data type of all these variables 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is integer. Okay, now this integer data type, it means all the variables are of same data type. So there has to be a method where we can have a single variable. What is required? A single variable, okay, which can store all values of same data type, and yes, it is necessary they are relevant to each other. Okay, they are relevant to each other. Okay, that is an important thing to understand. So it means we need not to be having this multiple variable concept in case of multiple values of same data type to store multiple. Instead of that, we should have a concept that all these values, okay, all these multiple values, multiple items of same data type can be stored in a single variable. Okay, so now due to this concept of array comes here. Okay, so concept of array is nothing but it is a data type. Okay, it is a data type, okay, which can hold multiple values of same data type. Okay, so we further exploring the concept of array, we have to see then how to declare this array. Okay, how array looks like, how to declare, how it is performed, and other things. Okay, so as this single integer is declared like this. Okay, now an array is declared like this. Okay, you can see there is a square bracket. Okay, so square bracket is nothing but an representation of array. Okay, and here you have seen that an integer is written. Okay, so this integer, which denotes number of elements in this array. Okay, and of course this is name of array. Okay, and it is an identifier. Now what is an identifier? It is a valid name, valid identifier rules it should follow. So then all the names of the variables that we can create, that is also applicable to the rule of name of array. Okay, and this, what is this? This integer is the data type of all the elements of this particular array. That is why I told you that this would be the same data type. This is that what? Same data type that we were talking about. Okay, so what does this mean? That it means that there are 10 integers which are collectively stored in an array whose name is A. Okay, so what does it mean? 10 integer elements are stored in a collective, with a collective name or with a collective structure, with a collective entity. That is, the entity is called A, and A is an array, and all the members of this particular array will be of type integer. Okay, now if you are able to understand this particular concept, then we also need to understand then how to initialize values of arrays. Okay, now I am simply drawing, every time you will see that I am simply drawing the analogy with the simple variables. Okay, so you can also find a differentiation between the normal variables and the array variables. Okay, and the data types that are of array are is of same. Okay, it is of same inbuilt data type. Okay, so it is a data type, but it is a user defined data type. Okay, it is a sort of user defined data type, because the number of elements in the array is normally defined as the perspective of the user application. Okay, so further, if I draw an analogy, how to initialize a variable with how to initialize a variable of an array. Okay, so I would simply write, I can write int A equals to 5. Okay, now this is an initialization step, because any value assigned during the declaration is called initialization. Okay, so the first value assigned to variable A is 5. Okay, so this is initialization. As we all know, this is done for the normal variable. Now this concept does not hold in initializing an array. Suppose I have this array integer A10. This means there is an array whose name is A, and it can store 10 elements of integer data type. Okay, now if I write like this, integer A equals to 5, no, this is not allowed in C programming. Okay, so you cannot write like this. Okay, it does not mean that all the elements will become 5 only, or some other interpretation cannot be taken from this. Instead of that, the correct syntax to initialize an array, suppose I take A5, it means the array of 5 elements, and I can write the equal to for assignment, and then I have to draw curly brace opening and closing for the purpose, and in the curly braces I will write the elements of this particular array, or collection of elements for this array in a sequential order. Okay, because array follows an order. Okay, so on the right side I am also writing properties of array, right? So the first property is that array is collection of same data type, collection of items of same data type. This is first property. Another property that we have seen just right now, that array maintains a sequence of elements. Okay, and each element has a index. Okay, now we will see this property, that writing A5, if I write like this 2, 4, 3, 1, 9, okay, now these are the 5 elements that will be stored, that will be stored in this particular array in the form of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbering. It is an order that 2 will come before 4, 3 will come before after 4, and 1 will come after 3, and 9 will come after. So it will follow the same order and with semicolon, and it will follow the same order for this particular sequencing or for the elements. Okay, now how to understand that, how this sequencing is maintained. Okay, now if for this particular purpose we have to understand that how this array is stored. Okay, so if I say that this array is stored like a sequence, okay, so this name is A, and there are space available for 5 integers. Okay, we will do it further, that how they are stored in memory, but for now, for understanding the array indexing, now we can understand that the indexes start from 0 and 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 4 is what, n-1. Suppose the array is of n elements, and for n elements, the highest index would be n-1. Why n-1? Because the array indexing starts from 0. Okay, this is a default thing that you have to remember for C programming, that array indexes start from 0. It means the index of the first element. Okay, and if I have written this statement, then this statement interprets like this: 2, 4, 3, 1, 9. Okay, so the sequence is maintained, the way the input was given, the same order is followed over here, and you can see that this happens like that. Okay, now what does it mean, that if I want to access this particular element, I will write this A2. Okay, why 2? 2 is index here. Okay, and in the declaration part, this particular thing is size of array. Okay, this particular thing is size of array, right? Size of array. Okay, but here it is index. Okay, so what you need to differentiate, that in the statement of initialization, when you initialize the array, you give size of array in square bracket. Fine, this thing you have to remember. But other than initialization, in whole program, whenever you write square bracket and an integer suppose an integer i in that, this will denote the index. Okay, only during the initialization, the value written, the integer written in the square bracket is size of array. In the declaration part and in the initialization part, okay, it is written as size of array. Otherwise, in whole program, every time if something in some integer is written in square bracket, it would be dealt as this index. Okay, and indexes start from 0. Each element has an index. Index start from 0 to n minus 1. Okay, and what is n? N is n elements. Okay, collection of n items. Okay, of same data type. Array maintains a sequence of elements. Each element has an index, and index start from 0 to and goes to n minus 1. Okay, now another property that we can see here for array is that array I will access how to access this A2. Writing A2 means the integer at the index 2, okay, so which is 3. So this is equivalent to 3. Okay, so if you want to access this 3, you will write A2. Okay, now what is if you want to access this 9? Okay, so you will simply write A4. Okay, A4, and if you want to replace this value, if you write A4 equals to 16. Okay, so what will happen? This 16 will override this value 9. Okay, so this will happen for the assignment of array. We will see it in detail for the